Let's say it is a nice summer night. You leave the windows open to enjoy some fresh air. All of a sudden you have a visitor. This visitor is a bat, that for some reason found itself to be your guest. And who likes bats as unexpected guests? Basically no one. You will instantly get a mix of feelings between scared and disgusted. Your instinct will tell you to hide from it, or if you find some courage you will try to chase it outside. Fixed in popular culture as an evil, blood-sucking monster, bats are synonymous with all that's dangerous and terrifying about the dark. The truth, of course, is very different, and the goal of this video is to change your perception on bats by showing you how they are helping farmers financially and how important they are to all the planetary ecosystems. Before going deeper into the topic, please consider supporting the channel by liking the video and subscribing. Thank you. But why are people afraid of bats in the first place? From the dawn of mankind, the night has terrified humans. At night, our vision fails, while predators, both real and imagined, may lurk behind every shadow. Our senses of sound and touch are heightened, our adrenaline pumps wildly. As we walk in the darkness, we suddenly hear a very unnatural flapping sound, so alien from the familiar sounds of flying birds. As we enter a cave or some ruins, already in a frightened state of mind, a swarm of bats arise in fear and anger at our intrusion. Their unearthly shrieks send us into panic. Their rough and leathery wings give us a sense of disgust. This is our primordial reaction to bats. Thanks to our ancestors and their way of life, we instinctively find bats unattractive and scary. Coming to the modern world, bats don't get the attention they deserve to debunk myths such as, they want to suck your blood, or, they carry deadly diseases. Only 3 of the roughly 1,300 existing bat species are vampire bats, and none of them live in the United States or Canada. Vampire bats don't really suck blood. They make a painless incision near an artery using their sharp teeth and then let the blood come out into a pool before licking it up. Vampires didn't even get the name from the bats, but the other way around. The mythologies existed in various cultures around the world long before vampire bats got their name. On the other hand, bats and flying foxes do carry bacteria and viruses which can be harmful to humans, but the risk of infection is very low. They are mostly known for the rabies virus, but only 0.5% of them carry it. Any warm-blooded mammal can contract the disease, but the primary carriers in North America are raccoons, skunks, bats, foxes, and coyotes. Thanks to an increase in pet vaccinations, wildlife now accounts for more than 90% of all reported cases, which are as low as 1 to 3 per year in the United States. Fortunately, rabies is 100% preventable in humans thanks to vaccination. The vaccine can be administered at 2 different times, given pre- or post-rabies exposure, but the post-exposure shot should be given not long after being exposed. With a mortality rate of 99.9%, rabies is the most deadly virus on the planet if left untreated, and treating it can be very costly, so, love your own, leave other animals alone, is a good principle for everyone to follow. Bats kill way less people in the United States than, say, dogs or deer. However, this might not be enough to change your perception of them, also considering that they are not the most good-looking animal in the wild. Unless you wrap them in blankets. They look very cute inside these colorful comforters. Anyhow, it is now time to show why you should be thankful to bats and their critically important role in all planetary ecosystems. Just like bees, bats are excellent pollinators. More than 500 species of plants rely on bats to pollinate their flowers, including mango, wild banana, and agave, which is used to make tequila. So, next time you drink some tequila or eat a mango, say thanks to the bats. But then the natural question comes to mind: why do these species of plants rely on bats when there are bees and other pollinators around? Plants pollinated by bats often have pale nocturnal flowers that bloom at night, which is the perfect time for bats as they are more active during the evening. Meanwhile, bees are attracted to bright, daytime flowers. Bats play an important role in helping the regrowth of lost forests. Like birds, some bats play a critical role in spreading the seeds of trees and other plants. Tropical fruit bats carry seeds inside them as they digest the fruit, then poop the seeds far away from the original tree. These seeds drop to the ground in their own ready-made fertilizer, which helps them germinate and grow. Bats are better than birds at this task as they are able to cover large distances during their nightly foraging flights, and are willing to enter deforested areas. While some people think bats are pests, some bats are actually pest controllers eating thousands of insects every night. Bats in North America won't bite you or suck your blood, but they will help clear the air of bloodsucking mosquitoes. All bats in the United States are insectivores, they only eat insects. These bats are great for keeping bugs away from crops, as well as saving money on pesticides for the farmers. Research organizations that have attempted to estimate the global value of bats to agriculture have arrived at staggering figures every time. According to recent studies, bats deliver $1 billion in value to the global corn industry and $3.7 billion to North American agriculture in general. So next time you have a bat as a guest, don't panic. It probably happened by mistake and it just wants to continue serving the planet. So open all doors and windows to outside and give it some time to find itself out. Remember to never touch it, as what you should do with any other wild animal. Thank you for watching and consider subscribing.